25 years ago that the late great Niki Lauda took his 25th and final Grand Prix win here at Zandvoort. He came from 10th on the grid to beat his McLaren teammate Alain Prost by just 0.2 seconds. Well, Zandvoort is a very different circuit today, of course, but still one with an incredible legacy. And we're going to add to that. Welcome along to the 2020 Dutch Grand Prix. Zandvoort circuit, 14 corners, 10 to the right and 4 to the left, with plenty of steep camber and elevation changes to keep our drivers on their toes throughout a 2.6 mile lap. Anthony Davidson is with me once again to take you through today's action, and we have plenty of twists and turns to come over the next hour or so, I'm sure.
Well, to start with, I have to feel bad for Carlos Sainz. He gave it everything he had in qualifying, but he just couldn't get the performance he needed, and he's starting well behind where he should be. And let's see who's able to keep their tyres in that temperature sweet spot early on. You've got a great tyre warmer underneath your right foot, and the drivers need to make the most of that on the formation lap, lest they see themselves skating wide at turn one on cold rubber.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Joker lines up on pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Albon, Valtteri Bottas, and Leclerc, Perez, Ricciardo, Stroll, and Lando Norris. Sainz, Grosjean, Pierre Gasly, and Ocon, Magnussen, Kvyat, George Russell, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Raikkonen, and Nicholas Latifi. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's...
Okay, our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. That's a good start. Keep it up. teammate by 3.2 seconds. Your overtake button more, it's time to utilize some of this energy. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. Job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. To pit this lap, so push now. Expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. go. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. Somewhere on the ICE, be aware that we will start to see a loss of power.
Fuck.
Just fitted the hard tires. Car behind, running hards. Gap to teammate behind is 5.6 seconds. Thank you. There's some kind of problem with their car. Okay, that was a nasty hit. Turn the engine off and wait for the marshals. Caution, caution. The virtual safety car is out. Reduce speed and maintain a positive delta. Drop your speed. Our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. Okay, clear. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Is 9.4 seconds. Plus 1 lap of extra fuel. Fuel target plus 1. Thank you. two laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. We're leading our teammate by 14.5 seconds. Job, you've done everything we wanted today.
A difficult race then on a circuit that demands complete concentration, but they persevered to take the win here today. So Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection. A shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
And here we are, a team that is no stranger to the podium, taking their place on top once again. A sublime race today, and a stunning win for Ferrari. It increases their championship lead. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
I have to give it to Joker. They fought so hard and had incredible pace at times, so I don't think anyone else did a better job today.
Let's move on to the constructors. Ferrari continued to extend the gap at the top of the table. Meanwhile, Renault move up the table with another strong performance this weekend. After an event like that, who knows?